Hi there and welcome to this video. Ubuntu 24.04 LTS is out. That is a long-term supported version and that is the latest as of 2024. Let's see how we can install Ubuntu 24.04 LTS in Vultr and log in. So let's go back to Vultr, whatever you want to call it. I'm here under products in Vultr. If you don't have a Vultr account, you can use my link in the description and that's going to give you $100 free credit from Vultr. That is only available to new Vultr accounts. If you have an existing account, then that will not apply to you. Let's see how to deploy Ubuntu 24.04 in Vultr. So I'm here on products, just click on deploy and there are multiple deploy buttons on Vultr. Just find one deploy button and click to deploy a server. I'm going to click deploy server. But first of all, I want you to create an SSH key and we're going to use that SSH key to set up our server and log in with that. That is the right way to do things. And so I'm just going to show you, first of all, how to create the SSH key on your computer. So if you're following along with me on Windows, make sure you download Git, install Git, and then Git is going to come with Git Bash. So open that. I'm also doing this tutorial on Windows and I'm using Git Bash. If you're on Linux or Mac, you can always use the terminal that comes with your computer. I'm going to open Git Bash. So first of all, install Git and then after that, open Git Bash. Let's generate the SSH key. I've already written the commands down here to save time. And I'm going to add this in the description below. I will explain it. SSH keygen, as the name suggests, that is a command that is going to generate our SSH key. Dash T, that's the type of the key. And the type of the key we're going to generate is that. And then the file name, that is the file name. And then this is where our key is going to get stored. It's going to get stored in the SSH folder, in a folder called Vultr. And the name of the key will be key one. So let's just copy this. You can just copy and follow along with me. I will put this in the description. Paste, enter. When you're generating an SSH key, you can always enter a passphrase, and a passphrase is important to secure your key. That is a second level of security for your key. If somebody gets the key and they don't know the passphrase, they cannot use it. So I'm just going to escape that. I'm just going to press enter. Okay, so I see I made a small mistake here, and this is a good thing actually. Failed, no such file or directory. So the reason for that is because this does not exist. This directory does not exist. To create the directory, it's not a difficult process. Let's just create the directory first of all. So to create the directory is simply mkdir and I will do dash p and I will paste the directory. So this folder does not exist. That's why I'm getting that error. So if you do dash p, it's going to create any folder that does not exist. Paste, enter. So I'm going to press the up arrow to go back to this command. And then I'm just going to press enter, enter to skip this. And now our key has been generated and stored inside of that directory. So we have the key1.pub and the key1, which is a private key. So we need to add this key to Vultr. So I'm going to copy it, copy, and I'm just going to do Control L to clear this screen. To paste inside of Git Bash, you can do Shift Insert. And we want to open this. I want to open this with Visual Studio Code. So I'm just going to do code. That's going to open that file in VS Code. And I can just copy it because I'm going to need it in a moment. So this is the one I need to add inside of Vultr. So let's go back to Vultr and I'm going to choose the parameters for my Ubuntu server. So choose the type of the server, optimized cloud. Of course, that's expensive. We don't need that. We're just going to go with cloud compute shared. We are going to choose a location in America. I will go with ETL and then choose the image. So here you can choose Ubuntu. I'm going to go with Ubuntu, but there are all these other options that you can choose. Even Windows is there. So I'm going to select Ubuntu 24.04 LTS. And then I need to choose a server type. You can choose AMD High Performance, Intel High Performance, High Frequency, Regular Cloud. I'm going to stick with AMD, and I'm just going to stick with the 2GB, which is $12 a month. You can see down here, it's $14.40, but you're going to see why. But this is $12 a month. Additional features, you can add auto backups. So this is what's increasing our price to $14.40. And that is 20% of your server. That is automatic backups. If your server is crucial, of course, enable automatic backups. And I'm just going to uncheck that. I understand disable automatic backups. Of course, I want IPv6. If you don't want IPv4, you don't need it. You can disable that as well, and you won't get an IPv4 address. DDoS protection is $10 a month. If you want that, select that. VPC cloud, if you have virtual private clouds set up on your Vultr, you can use that. You can select your VPC from there. And then limited user account, I can see this is a new feature here that allows you to create a new user. I don't know that you can create it. Okay, it seems like Vultr is going to create it for you. So I'll just uncheck that. So what this is, it allows you to create a sudo user that gives you access to administrate your server without having to use the root user. And that is more secure, but I'm going to uncheck that. I don't want to use that. If you know about cloud init, you can use cloud init user data to do certain things to your server when you're deploying it. And then server settings, choose SSH key. So this is the first step we did, which was generate the key. And you've seen how to do that. And we're going to add our SSH key there. And then paste in the public key there. So this is a key I've copied from VS Code. Add SSH key. I'm going to select my key from here. I've added the key. Now I can select it from here, key one. And if you have a firewall group that you've set up on Vultr, you can select it from there. Server host name. Of course, give your server a fully qualified domain as a server host name. So I'm going to give it a host name of sample.bizanosa.com. This is going to be your server label as well, but you can change the label there. So the label is just the name that you'll see in your Vultr dashboard. All right, so that's pretty much all the settings I need for my server. Most importantly, we want to deploy Ubuntu 24.04. I'm going to deploy now. And once it's deployed, we're going to see how to log in. There we go. Our server has been deployed. So we can copy the IP address and come back to login. You'll see I have this login to my server, and you can SSH into your server. Root is a user. So if you chose a different user, if you have a different user, of course, log in with that user. And then I'm going to paste in my IP. And this is the identity of your key. So your key will be stored there. This is the name of your key. If I go to this directory, I'm going to see two keys there. One is a public key, one is a private key. So I'm going to SSH into my server using that. So just remember username, IP address, identity of your key. So if you gave your key a different name, this is the name of the key, then use that. I'm going to paste in that and then enter. I'll just type yes. All right, so we're logged into our server. I'm going to do Control L to clear the screen. The next step, I'm going to update the server. So you can see I'm using sudo for root, even though I don't need it. I'm just going to use it. And the reason for that is because you may be using a different user that is not the root user, and you may need, and you'll need sudo to do this command. So this is to update the server. So first of all, you're going to update the cache here, and then you're going to upgrade any applications that need to be upgraded. Then enter. Do you want to continue? You can just press enter to continue. But to avoid that, I'm going to add dash y to the command. So when you get it, you won't need to press enter. It will automatically upgrade everything. And that's what dash y does. Let me run that again, see if there's still any updates. Okay, so it seems like Vultr, in the process of installation, usually also updates the server. So I'm just going to do Control L to clear the screen again. And we can confirm the version of Ubuntu we are running. If you just do hostname, control, this is going to give us some details about our VPS. So static hostname is sample, and that's the one you're seeing there. Your icon name, this are probably set by Vultr. The chassis is a VM. That just tells you that this is a virtual machine. It is virtualized from another computer, machine ID, boot ID, virtualization, Microsoft. I don't know. I think that's Hyper-V. And then operating system, Ubuntu 24.04 LTS. And then you can see our kernel is a recent one, 6.8 generic. And then the architecture, 64-bit system, hardware vendor is Vultr, hardware model, VHP. All right, in this video, you've seen how you can deploy Ubuntu 24.04 on your Vultr. And I've said, if you need $100 free credit, you can get that in the description below. You've also seen how you can deploy SSH key and use that SSH key to log into your server. If you have any questions about this, feel free to let me know. Let's see how to destroy the server. I'm just going to click there. This server destroy. Note that if you stop the server, you'll still get charged. So it's always a good idea to destroy the server if you don't need it. So yes, destroy this server, and then click on the destroy button, and that's going to destroy that server. There we go. That's the end of the video. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know.